Hello everyone, I am Leelavati, your Maths teacher. Today I will discuss about the continuation class of real numbers. Revisiting rational numbers and their decimal expansion. In class 9, you studied that rational numbers have either a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. For example, here you consider first one, 3.4738 is there. This one is a terminating decimal. Next, second one is 3.4254. Here continuous numbers are there. This one is considered as a non-terminating decimal expansion, repeating decimal expansion or reoccurring. In this section, we are going to consider a rational number, say P by Q. Here Q does not equal to 0. And explore exactly when the decimal expansion of P by Q is terminating and when it is non-terminating, repeating or reoccurring. We do so consider several examples. For example, here total 4 examples are there, but I will consider only 2 examples. Remaining 2 you solve yourself. First one, 0.375. 0.375 is equal to, here point after 3 numbers are there, that one can be written as 375 divided by 1000. Why you take here 1000 means point after 3 numbers are there. Next is equal to 375, keep it as it is, denominator 3 zeros are there. This can be written in the form 10 to the power of 3. After that you consider numerator 375. Here this can be expressed as the prime numbers. 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. Next, 1 is there, 3 5s are 50, 5 2s are 10, remaining 2 is there, 5 5s are 25, 5 5s are 25, 5 1s are 5. This can be written in the form, here 3 is there, 3 keep it as it is, into 5 3 times repeated. This can be written in the form, 5 to the power of 3 divided by 10 can be written in the form, 2 5s are 10, here cube is there, cube. Next, 3 into 5 to the power of 3 divided by, this is of the form identity a by b to the power of n equal to a to the power of n into b to the power of n. This can be written in this form, 2 to the power of 3 into 5 to the power of 3. Here 5 to the power of 3, 5 to the power of 3 get cancelled. Remaining numbers are 3 by 2 to the power of 3. Second one, 0.104 is there. This can be written in the form 0.104 equal to, here also point after 3 numbers are there, 104 divided by 1000. 104 keep it as it is, divided by, here 3 zeros are there. This can be written in the form 10 to the power of 3. After that you consider numerator 104. This can be written in the form of prime factors, 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4. Next, 2 2s are 4, remaining 1 is there, 12, 2 6s are 12, 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 13 itself a prime number, 13 1s are 13. Next, here 104 can be expressed as prime factors, here 2 3 times repeated. This can be written in the form 2 to the power of 3 into, here 13 is there, 13. 10 can be written in the form 2 5s are 10. Again you use the identity a into b to the power of n equal to a to the power of n into b to the power of n. Next, 2 to the power of 3 into 13 divided by 2 to the power of 3 into 5 to the power of 3. Here numerator and denominator same numbers are there, get cancelled. Remaining numbers are 13 divided by 5 to the power of 3. Next, do you see any pattern? It appears that we have converted a real numbers whose decimal expansion terminates into a rational number of the form P by Q, where, see this one, given question is decimal expansion, but here converted this one as a rational numbers. Rational numbers means P by Q form, where P and Q are co-prime. Already you know the previous class, co-prime means their highest common factor is 1. Here also P and Q have highest common factor is 1, and the prime factorization of the denominator as only power of 2 or power of 5 or both. You say this line, meaning you see the denominator here, here only 2 to the power of 3 is there, 5 to the power of 3 is there. Okay, other this denominator contains both. Next, where the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m, and n, m are some non-negative integers. Next, I will go to the exercise 1.4. Without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. First one is 13 divided by 3125 is there. Here 13 itself are prime numbers. Prime numbers means it divisible by 1 and itself only. Keep it as it is. And denominator can be converted in prime factorization. Consider a denominator. Here last number is 5. 5 6 is 30. 31 minus 30 is remaining 1 is there. 5 2 is 10. Remaining 2 is there. 5 5 is 25. Next 5 1 is 5. Remaining 1 is there. 12. 5 2 is 10. Remaining 12 minus 10 is 2 is there. 25. 5 5 is 25. 5 2 is 10. Remaining 2 is there. 5 5 is 25. 5 5 is 25. 5 1 is 5. Again you write here 13, keep it as it is in denominator, prime factors 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 5 numbers are there, this can be written in form 5 to the power of 5, this one is a terminating, why you consider here terminating means, here consider rational numbers is of the form P by Q form is there, already you know the condition, you consider this one as a terminating decimal means, here Q is either in the form of 2 to the power of N, 5 to the power of M. Otherwise, it contains only one term, 2 to the power of n or 5 to the power of m. Otherwise, it contains both the term. That one you consider as a terminating. For example, first one, 3 divided by 5 to the power of 2 is there. This one is a terminating. Another one example is there, 3 divided by 2 to the power of 4, 5 to the power of 2, 7. This one is a non-terminating decimal because here denominator contains only 2.5. But here 7 is there. Therefore, this one is a non-terminating decimal expansion. Next, I will go to the second question. 17 divided by 8. Here also 17 is itself a prime number. Keep it as it is. 8 can be written in the form 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. 2 is 3 times repeated, 2 to the power of 3. Here denominator contains only 2 to the power of n form. Therefore, this one is a terminating decimal expansion. Next, I will go to the third question. 64 divided by 455 is there. 64 is a number. This can be written in the form of prime factor. 64. 2 3 is 6. 2 2 is 4. 2 1 is 2. Remaining 1 is there. 2 6 is 12. 2 8 is 16. 2 4 is 8. 2 2 is 4. Here 2 6 times repeated. 1 2 3 4 5 6. This can be written in the form of 2 to the power of 6. Next. Similarly, you write the denominator in the form of prime factorization. 455 is there. 5 9s are 45. 5 1s are 5. Next 7 1s are 7. 9 minus 7 is 2 is there. 21 remaining. 7 3s are 21. Next 13 itself a prime number. 13 1s are 13. Here denominator you write a 5 into 7 into 13. Here you see here 5 is there. But remaining 2 numbers are there. 7 and 13. Therefore this one is a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Why it is non-terminating means here denominator contains 7 and 13. You consider this one as terminating means denominator contains only 2 to the power of n or 5 to the power of m, otherwise contains both. Next I will go to the fourth question. 15 divided by 1600. 15 can be written in form 3 pi is 15. Denominator can be expressed in the form of prime factorization. 2 8 is 16. Keep it 0, 2 zeros as it is. Next, 2 4s are 8. Remaining 2 zeros, 2 2s are 4. Remaining 2 zeros, keep it as it is. 2 1s are 2. Remaining 2 zeros, 2 5s are 10, 0. 2 2s are 4. 5 minus 4 is 1 is there. Remaining 10. 2 5s are 10. 5 5s are 25. 5 1s are 5. Here, 2 how many times repeated? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. Therefore, you can write this one as a 2 to the power of 6. And 5 is 2 times. 5 into 5. 5 square. Here 1 5 1 5 get cancelled. Remaining numbers are there 3 to the power of 6 into 5. This one is a terminating. Why you consider this one is a terminating means here 2 and 5 is there. Next, fifth question, 29 divided by 3, 43 is there. 29 itself a prime number. You can split the denominator 3, 43 can be expressed in the form of prime factorization. 3, 43. 7, 4s are 28. Remaining 6 is there. 7, 9s are 63. Next, 7, 7s are 49. 7, 1s are 7. 343 can be written in the form 7 to the power of 3. Here denominator contains 7, therefore this one is a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Next I will go to the 6th question. 23 divided by 2 to the power of 3 into 5 to the power of 2 equal to, here directly given denominator contains 2 to the power of n form and 5 to the power of m form, therefore this one is a terminating. Next 7th one, 129 divided by 2 to the power of 2, 5 to the power of 7, 7 to the power of 5. You see this one here, 7 is there. Therefore, this one is a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Next, 8th one, 6 divided by 15 is there. 6 can be written in the form 2, 3 is a 6. 15 can be written in the form 3, 5 is a 15. Here, 3, 3 get cancelled. Remaining numbers are 2 divided by 5. Here, 5 is there. This one is a terminating. Next, 9th question, 35 divided by 50. 35 can be written in the form 7, 5 is the 35. 50 can be expressed in the form of prime factors. 50. 2, 2 is the 4. Remaining 1 is there. 2, 5 is the 10. 5, 5 is the 25. 5, 1 is the 5. Here you can write in denominator 2 into 5 into 5. Here 1, 5, 1, 5 get cancelled. 7 divided by 2 into 5. Here denominator contains 2 to the power of n form and 5 to the power of m form, both contain, therefore this one is a terminating. Next, 10th question, 77 divided by 2, 10. 77 can be written as 7 into 11. Next, denominator can be expressed in prime factorization. 2, 10. 2, 1s are 2, remaining 2 numbers. Suppose you take remaining 2 numbers, you put a here 0. Next, 2, 5s are 10. 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5, 3 7s are 21, 7 1s are 7. Here denominator you write this one as a 2 into 3 into 5 into 7. Here 7, 7 get cancelled. Remaining numbers are 11 divided by 2 into 3 into 5. This one is a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion because denominator contains 3. Thank you.